Hi there. Today we're making a side dish of cowboy potatoes, baking it in a Dutch oven.
For this one, I'm going to use a 12-inch Dutch oven.
There's what they look like. Catfish got nice crust. All right, I've got 2.5-ish pounds of red potatoes here. I had a 5-pound bag that was about half gone, so I had to use it up anyhow. But that's all I've got, and I've got one small onion sliced up into little slivers. I'm going to add a stick of melted butter. Toss these around real good. Season them with some salt and pepper. Woo. Might be a little peppery. Look at these guys moving around a little bit here. Get some of that pepper to disperse. And some oregano. I think ideally Spanish oregano would have been probably better, but or more cowboy-ish. I think regular oregano should work okay. There we go. And there we go. How about a small amount of red pepper flakes. Okay, so this is not hot yet, so set that right there because I don't want to get the inside too dirty. And that is, yep, that'll work. There's all our potatoes and our nice seasoned buttery goodness. And they're sticking to the pan. And we'll just, there we go. Here and I think that is as much as we're going to get out of that. There we go, and we'll let that cook for about an hour. Okay, so while the potatoes are over there doing their thing, get the rest of our dinner going for tonight. Got a two flat iron steaks I picked up from Kroger not too long ago, and they were on sale. Froze them. I've just got them seasoned lightly with some kosher salt. That's not going to work, but I want to get a good sear on them, so I'm going to set that kind of like right there over the hot part. That's my wife's steak. It gets cooked a lot longer than mine, so get a good sear going on it on both sides, and then I'll transfer it over a little bit. Okay, so I had some dinner rolls cooking over here too. So when they got done, I just transferred all the coals over here. Everything from the bottom is also on top now. So I've just been hitting it with top heat for the last 15 minutes or so. Let's just see how we're looking here. Looking not too bad. Let me find a fork and taste one of them. Doesn't look too bad. Probably a little done for me. Yeah, did lose a little bit of it squishy.
We just use the same one.
Yeah. Go ahead and start fixing you up a plate with me.
That's for me.
It is.
Okay.
More?
Nope.
The video is going at the same time.
I'm sorry. Those potatoes, like a big bite of pepper or something.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sorry. Yeah. Ooh. The pepper comes out fast. All right. So. Let me show you my plate here. Got my steak. Some of the steak juice is mixing in with the green beans. a little dinner roll, been gnawing on it, and then our potatoes.
Potatoes are really good. Especially the ones that got some good crispy on them. Yeah, that's good. I like them. My wife does not.
I would have bypassed the ones that were heavily peppered.
Well, you can't tell that.
Until you bite into it, yeah. So I can look at them and tell.
Okay. And the green beans, they... good. Heat it through. Just a can of green beans and Rotel. There were no salt green beans, so I am going to put a little salt on them. They're pretty good. I like the potatoes, though. I love that flame wick sear on a steak.
That's really good.
Steak juices are good on the dinner roll too. Well, thank you for hanging out with us this afternoon. Really appreciate it. We'll see you next time. Thank you.